Within the next couple of minutes, we will look at two aspects. First of all, we will look at geographical distribution of hybrid beds, meaning if front and lobe fringes are really enriched in hybrid beds compared to lateral lobe fringes. And secondly, we will have a look at the hypothesis that hybrid beds are more common at the initiation and growth phase of submarine fans. For this purpose, we use deposits exposed in the Karoo Basin in South Africa. We used Fan 4 of the Tankwa Depot Center for the geographical trend analysis, and Unit A of the Lengsburg Formation and the Lengsburg Depot Center for the stratigraphical analysis. Altogether, we evaluated more than 23,000 individual beds. Here you can see a simplified outline of Lobe Complex 1 of Fan 4 of the Schwarzenberg Formation, sometimes also referred to as the lower fan. We plotted logs from the proximal area up to the sand pinch out and chose an approximate dip section to evaluate the distribution of hybrid beds in terms of flow events and bulk thickness. When you look at part B of the figure on your left side, you see that in terms of flow events, the proportion of hybrid beds is pretty low up until the spike occurs close to the sand pinch out, where almost a third of the succession is made up by hybrid beds. In terms of the bulk thickness of hybrid beds, there's a steady increase and also a spike occurring close to a sand pinch out that then abruptly dips. If we look at the lateral margin of the slope complex, for example, at a core location collected during the NOMAD project, we see that there are zero hybrid beds there. So basically, the model that we proposed for lobe deposits also works for lobe complexes, and our study also conforms quantitatively what we have reported qualitatively. Let's quickly look at the stratigraphical evidence, shall we? As mentioned, we employed data from Unit A of the Lengsburg Formation, which can be divided into five subunits, and these five subunits in turn comprise nine sand-prone lobe complexes. The lobe complexes are separated by either silt-prone lobe complex fringes or hemipelagic intervals. If we have a quick look at the upper part of the statistical figure, we can see that the lobe complex fringes have a maximum of about 2% of hybrid beds event. This again underlines that lateral lobe fringes are very poor in hybrid beds. To simplify the data set somehow, let's just look at the sand-prone lobe complexes now. The two different colors in the left-hand figure indicate two different core locations. Blue is for BSL, which is located relatively updip, and the violet is for BUF1B, which is located relatively down-dip of the BSL log. The data set doesn't conform with the assumption that hybrid beds are most common at the initiation phase of the fan. In fact, the highest proportions of hybrid beds can be found late into the fan growth, while our first lobe complex has almost no hybrid event beds. Only around 3% of flow events in the first lobe complex are counted as hybrid beds. Looking at the lobe complexes in detail, and here we have, for example, lobe complex A2 and A3 from both cores, we can see that hybrid beds can appear all over the succession in one lobe complex, but are generally enriched at the base and the top. When we now combine what we have learned from the geographical part of the study, a fair assumption is that stacking patterns are the paramount factor on the occurrence of hybrid beds in 1D data sets like these. This in turn explains the missing stratigraphical trends. To now quickly wrap up the presentation, we can say that geographical as well as stratigraphical occurrence of hybrid beds are predominantly governed by autogenic lobe processes. If you want to know more details about the study, I would like to refer you to our paper, which was published in 2017. Finally, I would like to thank the sponsors of the Lobe 2 Joint Industry Project, and thank you for your attention.